Hello and welcome to my Q&A video series on the pandas library in Python. So the question for today is, how do I read a tabular data file into pandas? Great question. So what is tabular data? Quick reminder, tabular data is just data that looks like a table, meaning data with rows and columns, looks like an Excel spreadsheet. That's all a tabular data file is. Common formats like CSV, comma separated value, that's tabular data. Okay, so if we're gonna read it into pandas, we first need to import pandas. And the conventional import is import pandas as PD. And then we're gonna use an example data set that I've picked out. And that data set is a data set of Chipotle orders, the Chipotle restaurant chain, online orders, okay? And we're gonna use, to read it in, we're gonna use the read underscore table function. So pd.read underscore table. And then for me, what I could do is to say data slash chipotle.tsv. Now, chipotle.tsv is the name of the file, and it's in the data subdirectory relative to my working directory. So read underscore table, the first argument is the name of the file or its path, and I can use a relative path here. Now, this would work for me, but it's not gonna work for you, and so I'm gonna give you something that will work for you. So, I want you to type this along with me, http://bit.ly/chips, okay? So, read underscore table can read directly from a URL, and at this URL, I have put the data file, okay? And we can even take a look at it. So I am just gonna put, I'm gonna run that URL in my browser, and what will come up is the underlying data file, okay? So when we run this, we get back a perfectly formatted data file. Looks great. So we've got the index on the side, we've got some column headers up top, and we've got the body, if you will, the data itself, kind of in the middle, okay? So this turned out perfectly. Now, why did it turn out perfectly? Well, because this file, the underlying data file, happened to be formatted perfectly that it would works with the read underscore table default parameters. Meaning, by default, read underscore table assumes that your file is tab separated, and this data file, chipotle.tsv, is tab separated, okay? Another thing is that it assumes that the first row is a header row, and this this file does have a header row, which is this right here, as you can see in the file. Okay, so this file, we got lucky. This one worked perfectly, and we'll it's how we like it. So we're gonna save it as a data frame object called orders. And then you can always look at the first five rows just to remind yourself of that without overflowing the screen, okay? All right, so that was an easy case. Let's take a harder case, all right? So this time, we're gonna say pd.read underscore table, and we're gonna pass it the URL, another bit.ly link, bit.ly/movie users. Okay, bit.ly/movie users. These are users of a website that rated movies. It's demographic information. So we'll run this. And this time around, you can tell something is clearly wrong because it put everything in one column. And you don't even have to open up the file to notice that there are these pipe characters that are separating the fields. And that's the problem. So we need to communicate to pandas that there is this pipe separator. Now, how do I tell that to read table? Well, what you want to do is Google pandas read underscore table, and you will be taken to this page, which is the documentation. And you will find things like the second argument here is called sep. and it's the delimiter to use, and the default, as I mentioned, is the tab character. So we need to instead tell pandas our separator is the pipe character. Okay. So when we run that, you see this looks a lot better than before, because now each of the fields are in their own column. Now that's not the only problem. There's also this problem that the first row is being interpreted as the header row, and it's not the header row, okay? So that's just a row of data. So we need to tell pandas that there is no header. Header equals none. And that's great. So it's now replaced it with default values, which are just integers, but at least now the data is in the data section of the data frame, if you will, okay? So there's one more thing here. We probably actually want to have column names so we can define them, all right? So I'm going to create a Python list called user calls, and it's going to be a list, and it's a list of strings. And I happen to know what each of these columns represents, so I'll just type these in here. The first column is user ID. The next is age. The third is gender. The fourth is occupation. And the fifth is zip code, okay? So I'm just creating a Python list of strings with column names, and then I'm gonna pass that to read underscore table. So I'm going to say names equals user calls. So I'm passing that list as the value of the argument names so that pandas knows to use those strings as the column names. So we'll run that, and now it looks perfect. And this is ready for us to work with. We can save it as an object like before, so this is now a data frame object, and then anytime we want to look at it, we can just print it out or look at the first five rows or whatnot, okay? So that is how you work through using read underscore table. If you have tabular data, just try reading it, see what happens. If it doesn't look right, just iterate through that process until you get it right. Look at the read table documentation, and you'll be able to figure out which arguments you need to tweak in order to get it to work, okay? So I'm always gonna end these videos with a bonus tip. The bonus tip for today is just a read table argument that I think is super useful. Actually, two arguments. One is skip rows, and the other is skip footer. So what do we use these for? Well, let's pretend you have a data file and someone has inserted some text or some notes at the top or the bottom of the file, and it's not really data, it's just notes about the file, but they put it in the file itself. You can use this to tell pandas, please skip those certain rows or at the top or at the bottom, so that it can just focus on the actual data part of the file, okay? All right, thanks so much for joining me. Please click subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and please let me know your pandas question in the comment section below, and I will probably answer it. I might even make a video about it, okay? Thanks so much, and I look forward to seeing you soon.